Now, what are true fats? True fats are of two types, basically hard fats and the oil fats. Remember, true fats are those which do not carry conjugate things. So simple fats, simple lipids are called as the true fats, or the neutral one are called as the true fats. And remember, they are of two types. If they are solid at the room temperature, or if they are liquid at the room temperature, so accordingly they are called as hard fats or the oil fats. And the hard one are also called as the animal fats, and plant one are also called as the plant fats. The main important word is plant oils. And they are solid at room temperature, they are liquid at room temperature of 20 degree, and please remember that their melting point is high. And bonds, remember one thing, that the longer the chain, the more will be the melting point. And in this side, you will find that there is a low temperature, and low temperature has something to do with the unsaturation. More the number of the single double bonds, lesser will be the melting point. So remember here, because single bonds are there, that's why this chain has a high melting point. And second point, because there is single bond and there is a long chain, so longer the chain, more will be the melting point. And shorter the chain, lesser will be the melting point. And in the case of unsaturated fatty acid, the number of double bonds will confirm that what will be the melting point. Higher the number of double bonds, lower will be the melting point. If all the three fatty acids are same, now remember this we discussed before, if all the fatty acids, see, monoglyceride has only one fatty acid. Diglyceride will have only two. Triglycerides will have three. So if these fatty acids are similar or dissimilar, accordingly types are possible. So if all the fatty acids are same, you will call it as a pure fat. And if only one or two or all the three fatty acids which are different, then it is called as a mixed fat. I hope this is easy and clear to you. So if that R1, R2, R3 are different, you will call it as mixed type. And if that R1, R2, R3 are of same type, you will call it as a pure fat. Now ghee, butter and all, they all are at semi-solid at room temperature. Only in winters they will become quite hard. The reason is because ghee and butter, they don't have a long chain. I have told you already, if the chain is not long, then it is going to be low melting point. Not so high, but low melting point. That's why ghee and butter, they stay as a semi-solid type because of short chain fatty acids are there. Now, there is something called as refined oils also. So what is refined oil? See, we all know plant oils are not pure. When they are extracted, they are not pure. So they will smell a lot, or their composition will not be good in taste. That's why refined oils have come into industries now. And how the refining of the oil is done? First of all, the free fatty acids, which are small, free fatty acids are removed with the help of alkalis. So any alkali, maybe of sodium and all, they are used for the removal of the free fatty acids, and followed by that, activated charcoal is used to remove the unwanted color, so that some transparent type of feature is given to the refined oil. Otherwise, the oil will remain to have some dark color to it. And then removal of odor, because there is an awkward smell in the normal plant oil. So that oil smell is removed with the help of superheated steam. So when all these things are done, that means treatment with the alkalis will cause the removal of the free fatty acids. Treatment with the activated charcoal will remove the color. And when superheated steam is made to pass through, it will remove all that odor or smell. Now this is converted into a refined oil and is made available in market to you. Now one more property of the fatty acids or fats, especially the plant fats, that they can easily undergo rancidity. What is rancidity? You must have seen when you eat walnuts and all, if you keep it broken into pieces and keep it open in air, exposed to the oxygen or the air, for a long time, you will find their taste will change. Even the groundnut, peanuts taste will change. So that unpleasant smell एंड टेस्ट विच डेवलप इन एन फैटी इन टू इन ए प्लांट ऑयल इज कॉल्ड एज द रेंसिडिटी और रेंसिड ऑयल. नाउ व्हाई इट बिकम रेंसिड, बिकॉज इट अंडरगोज कॉम्बिनेशन विद ऑक्सीजन in the region of double bond. Wherever there are double bonds, that means we're talking about the plant oils only. So plant oils will change their taste and smell and will be very awkward in taste and smell if they remain in contact with oxygen, because oxygen will replace that double bonds there, and finally it will turn into a solid, semi-solid type of oil, and its taste will be completely bad now. Now in the same manner, this is combination of oxygen. There is one more possibility: we can add hydrogen to the oil and then it will turn into solid form. This is done by addition of the hydrogen and it is called as hydrogenation. So what exactly happens is double bonds are replaced by the single bonds, and finally unsaturated fat has turned into a saturated fat. I hope this is clear to you.